The book revolves around a very small farm in the UK, in a very flat rural area of the UK. And at the beginning, we understand that there's a woman trying to get away from a farm, and more importantly, trying to get away from the farmer, from the man who runs this land. And the plot is as simple as it can get, really. It's the mission of her trying to survive each day on this farm, trying to find that inner strength, and finally trying to get away from him. I find it just really visceral. For me, claustrophobia or control within a domestic setting or within a relationship is utterly terrifying. It's that feeling of being smothered and being controlled in so many different ways. It's something I think we can all identify with on some level, but the way it happens to our protagonist in this story is so extreme, and I'm stunned in a way that she manages day to day to get through to the end of the day and to have the strength and the resilience and in her own heart the compassion and the kindness to actually live another day and to get through and survive. It's interesting, I didn't really choose it, it chose me. So I started off with a vision at midnight when I was in bed. I saw from an aerial perspective the farm, and I saw a small cottage, and I saw a figure moving in and out of the farmhouse and around the farmhouse, but she never went away very far. And I came to understand that she was being held captive there and she needed to get away. And then through that night up until 6 a.m., I had the entire story mapped out in my head. And I came to understand that she was Vietnamese, and I understood her backstory and where she had come from. I think subconsciously, I have Vietnamese family. My sister-in-law is Vietnamese, my niece and nephew live in Vietnam. So that could have perhaps planted a seed. But I think with stories, it's difficult to know really where they come from. The important thing is to kind of jump on the subject and go with it. So initially, it was that morning, you know, when my wife was asleep next to me, and I saw the book unfold inside my mind's eye, and I saw that he was controlling her in a very quietly menacing way. So she came to the farm with 17 possessions. And I think the idea for that came from research, understanding that people in that situation, they have a great deal of weight attached to those objects if they don't have so many of them. Whereas for people like me, it's objects become kind of, they have less value because you have so many of them. So by the time we get to page one of the book, she only has 4 possessions left, and they are key to her identity. We're talking about letters from her sister, the photo of her parents, her ID card, really, really important things for her. And he doesn't only destroy them by burning them, but he asks her to choose which object to burn. And I think I found that so viscerally kind of terrifying that it came out on the page in that way. Once I had finished the book, I wrote the first draft in 3 weeks. And it was like an exorcism. It flooded out onto the page, but then it took me the best part of 5 years to actually finish the book. And that's because I realized once I finished the first draft, this is actually a really serious, important topic, and I need to do my main character justice. So I went about doing as much research as I could. I spoke to Vietnamese women to read the book, and they gave me feedback, which was fantastic. I spoke to someone who was counseling victims of human trafficking, and she read an early draft of the book. And I felt like, do I have the right to write this book? So it took me 5 years really to think, I think I've done my main character justice, and I think I would be happy to see this on a bookshelf in a bookstore.